Hello everyone, welcome to Aptly Plus Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily news and editorial analysis which I'll be covering from the Hindu and Indian Express. So the most important news and editorial would be discussed in this session. So let's get started with today's topic list. Today is 2nd of October. The first topic is special panel to prove atrocities by police. Second, Indo-US industrial security joint working group. The third news, that is Foreign Secretary begin 4-day visit to Sri Lanka. Second last, September PMI signal upstick in the manufacturing expansion. And the last is in journey to recovery. So this is an editorial from Indian Express. Apart from this, there would be some current affair based MCQ questions. These questions would help you in the upcoming prelims examination. And those of you who are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe Aptly Plus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. Starting with the first news of the day, that is special panel to prove atrocities by the police, something which is important for your general studies paper 2, structure, organization, and function of executive and judicial. Now coming to the detail of the news, basically the Chief Justice of India, he has raised concern about the nexus between the bureaucrat, by bureaucrat, the CGI, I mean the police officer and the politicians. So the nexus has led to the standoff and ultimately the people are suffering. So what the Supreme Court is of the opinion, that a standing committee would be led by the Chief Justice of High Court to examine the complaint of atrocities committed by the police officers. ऐसी कोई भी घटना जिस पुलिस ऑफिसर्स के द्वारा की गई हो एंड द पीपल हु आर इन्वॉल्व आर बेसिकली बिलोंगिंग टू पुलिस ऑफिसर्स दे वुड बी एडिक्वेटली नीड टू बी पनिश्ड अंडर द सुपरविजन ऑफ अ कमिटी विच वुड बी हेडेड बाय द चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ हाई कोर्ट्स सो द सी जी आई हैज़ रेस्ड कंसर्न अबाउट द वे ब्यूरोक्रेसी पर्टिकुलरली द पुलिस ऑफिसर्स आर बिहेविंग इन द कंट्री बिकॉज ही हैज़ ऑल्सो रेस्ड अ कंसर्न जहाँ पे सी जी आई ने पहले भी कहा था कि प्रिजन खास करके जो पुलिस प्रिजन्स है वहाँ पे बहुत ही ज़्यादा ह्यूमन राइट्स की वॉलिश होती है राइट सो ही इज़ ट्राइंग टू रिफॉर्म इन दिस सेक्शन ऑल्सो एंड विच इज़ ऑन माई पर्सनल नोट इज़ वेरी एसेंशियल सो द बेंच हैज़ रिजर्व इट्स ऑर्डर ऑन अ सेपरेट पिटिशन विच वॉज फाइंड बाय द सीनियर IPS ऑफिसर्स हु वॉज सस्पेंडेड एज अ डायरेक्टर ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़ पुलिस अकेडमी एंड द FIR वॉज लॉन्च्ड अगेंस्ट बाय हिम बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट on the offences of seditions, corruptions and extortions, right? तो ये cases की खास करके जो order थी उसने Supreme Court ने reserve किया है और they are looking forward that how this nexus can come up between the bureaucrat that is politicians and bureaucrat that is police and the politicians. Now examples की अगर बात करें police brutality की so we have seen many cases. For example, in Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh they have been accused causing the death of the businessman during the raid in the hotel so it was being libeled that police ne bahut acche se treat nahi kiya because of which the businessman had died kuch aur cases mein in Tamil Nadu the CBI has charged 9 policemen right the 9 policemen were charged by the CBI in the custodial death of the father and son both and they have also instances of district administration's officers caught on video manhandling of the citizen during the lockdown So these are some of the cases of police brutality. Now the CGI, that is Mr. N.V. Ramana, he has said that he is a favor of standing committee headed by the Chief Justice of High Courts to investigate a complaint. Right? Jitne bhi complaints receive hote hain by the common man of the atrocities committed by the bureaucracy, especially by the police officers. Now a committee which would be headed by the Chief Justice of High Court would be giving their decision, which is very important. एंड द कॉमन विल गेट द रिलीफ जितने भी आम आदमी हैं उनको इस वजह इस डिसीजन के बाद काफ़ी ज़्यादा बेनिफिट्स मिलेंगे एंड द सुप्रीम कोर्ट बेंच हैज सेड दैट इट इज़ वेरी डिस्टर्ब बाय व्हाट ब्यूरोक्रेसी पर्टिकुलरली द पुलिस ऑफिसर आर डूइंग राइट उन्होंने कुछ बहुत ही हार्श कमेंट दिए हैं आई टेल यू व्हाट द CGI हैज़ टू से नाउ द CGI कैटेगोरिकली सेड दैट it is very disturbing for us no this is what the exact line he said that this is very disturbing for us that the bureaucracy is functioning not under the spirit of Indian constitutions right now moving on to the other news that is Indo-US industrial security joint working group something which is important for your general studies paper 2 bilateral regional grouping and agreement evolving India's and affecting India's interest. So India और United States के बीच में एक in principle approval हुई है to establish Indo-US Industrial Security Joint Working Group, और ये जो working group होगी this will meet periodically to align the policies, procedures, जिसको एक expeditiously basis पे काम की जाएगी in terms of defense industries. जो collaborations होगी that would be to provide the cutting edge defense technology between India and United States. So this is between India and United States to boost up the quality of defense technology. So industrial security agreement ki baat kare, this was held between the two sides September 27 and October 1. So factually also this is important for your prelims examination. And ISA was signed in December 2019 as a designated security authority, jo DSAs hain, unmein ye baat ki gayi thi ki they would be discussing a roadmap for the implementation of the ISA, right? ISA is Indo-US Security Joint Working Group. So the summit would be organized to develop a protocol of exchange classified informations between the defense industries, both between the both countries, that is India and United States. Now, agar baat kare General Security of Military Information Agreement, so in 2002, dono countries ne ek agreement signed ki thi, which is known as GSOMIA. You can read the entire full form from here. And the aim of this initiative was to ensure standard of safeguard critical information sharing by the US and India. Aur ye part hai GSOMIA ki, aur ISA is again would be aiding, would be boosting up overall US defense equipment, making bidder a big ticket in the contract of tie between the Indian private firms. So here the private participations become very important. India would be collaborating between United States with all its stakeholders who are also belonging to the private players. Now baat kare LEOMO ki, that is Logistic Exchange Memorandum of Agreement. So in 2016 the United States has declared major defense partner and signed the Logistic Exchange of Memorandum of Agreement. और इस एग्रीमेंट के थ्रू जितने भी मिलिट्रीज हैं बोथ साइड कैन यूज बेसिस एंड रिपेयर रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर सप्लाईज एज वेल एज प्रोवाइड फॉर द स्ट्रॉन्ग टाइज. सो अगर बात करें LEMO LEOMA की, दिस हैज बिकम अ वेरी पिवोटल बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स टू एस्टैब्लिश अ लॉजिस्टिक्स एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द टू कंट्रीज. और ये ऐसी एग्रीमेंट है जहाँ पे हमारे जो डिफेंस इक्विपमेंट है, जितने भी मिलिट्रीज इक्विपमेंट्स है, वो दोनों कंट्रीज के बीच में एक अच्छी कोऑर्डिनेशन वे में अभी तक सक्सेसफुल रही है. नाउ इन 2018 दे हैव आल्सो इन द कम्युनिकेशन कैपेबिलिटी एंड सिक्योरिटी एग्रीमेंट, जिसको कॉम कैसा कहते हैं, एंड फॉर इट इंटरपोलेबिलिटी बिटवीन द टू मिलिट्रीज प्रोवाइडिंग सेल ऑफ हाई एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, राइट. तो जितने भी हाई एंड टेक्नोलॉजी है विथ रिगार्ड टू द मिलिट्री इक्विपमेंट्स, दिस इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस, राइट. And in 2020, the two countries signed the Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement, which is also known as BECA, BECA, where they can have a share of high defense technology, geospatial map, classified satellite data with their militaries. So with their militaries, I mean India as well as United States. Now, Foreign Secretary began a four-day visit to Sri Lanka, which is important for General Studies Paper 2, India and its neighborhood relations. So, India ki jo Foreign Secretary hai, is on a visit to Sri Lanka, and this visit is very important, although he is visiting for the first time because of the COVID-19, many of the restrictions were there. So, he is visiting for the first time where the top leader, basically, jo wahan pe visit ho rahi hai, wo wahan ke president aur wahan ke prime minister se मिलेंगे, एंड ही विल रिव्यू द बायलेटरल टाइज बिटवीन द इंडिया एंड श्रीलंका, राइट. सो द विजिट वुड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टूवर्ड्स अ लॉन्ग स्टैंडिंग मल्टी फेसेट रिलेशनशिप, जहाँ पे कोशिश की जाएगी कि दोनों कंट्री के बीच में जो बायलेटरल पार्टनरशिप्स हैं उसको दे वुड अगेन गिव अ बूस्ट. इट वुड बी एक्टिंग एज अ कैटलाइजर्स, एंड अगेन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इंडिया एंड श्रीलंका वुड बैक टू नॉर्मल. इंडिया के जो फॉरेन सेक्रेटरी है, जो विजिट हुई है, ये प्रोवाइड करेगी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर द न्यू रिवाइवल ऑफ बायलेटरल टाइज, प्रोग्रेस ऑफ ऑनगोइंग बायलेटरल प्रोजेक्ट्स, एंड टैकल द कोविड रिलेटेड डिस्ट्रप्शंस की वजह से जितनी भी चीज़ों में प्रॉब्लम्स आई है इन टर्म्स ऑफ ट्रेड, इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज ऑफ एक्सचेंज प्रोग्राम्स, या फिर ट्रैवल की बात करें, सो ऑल थिंग्स वुड बी शॉर्टेड. and he will assess the infra projects progress of the Tamil reconciliations. So Tamil reconciliation is something which is very important both for India as well as for Sri Lanka. और रिसेंटली अगर बात करें जो अडानी ग्रुप है उन्होंने वहाँ पे एक एग्रीमेंट किया श्रीलंकन गवर्नमेंट के साथ एंड द पोर्ट अथॉरिटी टू डेवलप कोलंबो पोर्ट वेस्ट इंटरनेशनल कंटेनर टर्मिनल और ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोजेक्ट है श्रीलंका में एंड द टोटल एस्टिमेशन कॉस्ट वुड बी अराउंड 700 मिलियन बिल्ट ऑपरेट ट्रांसफर डील एंड इज द लार्जेस्ट फॉरन इन्वेस्टमेंट एवर बाय द पब्लिक पोर्ट इन द आइसलैंड नेशंस. So these two points is factually important for your mains examination. Now September PMI signal uptick in manufacturing expansion. This is something which is important for General Studies Paper 3. Indian economy and issues related to mobilization, planning, resources, growth and development. So according to IHS market survey which is Purchasing Manager Index, ye har bar apni index ko update karte hain and this show what is the actual performance of India's economy. तो इस बार बताई गई है कि जो manufacturing activity है वो काफ़ी expand हुई है and it has improved compared to the previous months. And the PMI has signaled that the raw material shortage and the high fuel transport cost intensify the price pressure post input cost to 5-month high. Now more about the index. So the index has rose from last month जहाँ पे अब की जो data है that is 53.7. In August, it was 52.3, right? So this is straight 3-month expansion, which we can see through the PMI. Or consumer goods ki agar baat kare, high growth in the output and international scale up has been seen. Or business confidence is again improved, and this is giving a positive sentiments to the economy, which was severely hit by the pandemic. So expectations hain ki jo production hai, wo aane wale samay mein bhi achhi tarah se growth kare. However, if you talk about employment, they have shown little changes. यहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा employment में भी data में we are not finding major changes, but we can expect that employment would also be improving. And PMI survey, which is in July reported to be redemptions hiring 15-month job losses, saw manufacturing pause in the high in the August. So in the month of August, most of the sector have seen a pause in hiring of the new recruitees. So the firm reported cited favorable market conditions जहाँ पे volumes की अगर बात करें वो उसमें भी गिरावट देखी गई है and aided by the ease of COVID-19 restrictions and strengthening the demand. So once after the festive season is over, we can get an idea that in which directions the COVID-19 cases would go and this would be the deciding factor that how the remaining part of the economy recovery would be taking its path. Now just to tell you a short news which I consider not very important, so I have not used this on the particular headline, but this you must know, jo Chacha Chaudhary is now a mascot of Namami Gange program. This is a very short news which cannot be discussed in detail. So just to tell you ki aapke agar prelims mein questions aate hain ki Namami Gange program mein kaun si aisi mascot hai jo abhi use ki gayi hai, to bhi Chacha Chaudhary. Apart from UPSC, this can be significant for many other competitive examination. So just to give you the information, right? Now the other news, this is an editorial, Journey to Recovery. This is something important for General Studies Paper 2, Government Policies and Intervention for the Development of Various Sectors. Now under this editorial, I have segregated this into 5 subheads. That is Government Efforts, Economy Recovery During COVID, Indian Pavilion at Expo, Reform Initiative, Benefits to the Government Scheme and Conclusion. So there are total 6 subheads which I'll be discussing with you. And the theme is this editorial is Government Measures and Economy Recovery. This is being written by the Piyush Goyal. Now, baat kare, today is 2nd of October and this is a day which you tribute father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. We celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on this day. So the dream of New India, which was being dreamt by the Gandhiji, called for an inclusive growth, paradigm shift, Swachhta, Swaraj as a visible origin in the India, right? Which is what the government should strive for. Each and every individual should have a vision that we come across all this paradigm shifts, right? So agar baat kare India ki expectations ki, we have seen that the COVID-19 as an converting adversity into opportunity. Opportunity ki agar baat kare, jis tarah se pandemic ne India ko hit kiya, they have made India more self-reliance in terms of each and every sector. and make us less dependent on import, right? But definitely we have to improve that part also. We have to make our healthcare more robust. We have to make our technology more robust so that we can achieve something better and we can also contribute globally, right? So baat kare pure entire world ki, where the defensive during the pandemic, India's vision have been to assert reform, prepare India for sustained phase of higher growth. तो यहाँ पे कोशिश की गई कि कैसे आत्मनिर्भर भारत की जो स्कीम्स है उसको इम्प्लीमेंट करके इंडिया फाइट बैक कर सकती है एंड दे कैन बी अ रिवाइविंग इकोनॉमी एज वेल. नाउ सम गवर्नमेंट एफर्ट्स, तो गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट एफर्ट्स लिए हैं इन टर्म्स ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एक्सपोर्ट टू मेक इंडिया एन इकोनॉमिकल हब, और ये स्ट्रेंथन करेगी इंडिया की कैपेबिलिटीज को, चाहे वो टेक्नोलॉजिकल स्पेस में हो, आईटी सेक्टर्स में हो, फार्मास्यूटिकल्स में हो या फिर स्पेस टेक्नोलॉजीज में हो. So the country's development, research and innovation capabilities would reap benefits to the newest technology like artificial intelligence and robotics. Now the lessons learned from the pandemic have also increased our confidence. Jahan pe agar baat kare scientific entrepreneurship, research and development capabilities ki, so this has also increased and this has become more indigenous because of the reason that we are trying to make India more robust, more Atmanirbhar, more self-reliant. इकोनॉमिक रिकवरी ड्यूरिंग कोविड-19 की अगर बात करें, वी हैव सीन अ रिकॉर्ड ग्रोथ ऑफ 20.1% इन द फर्स्ट क्वार्टर, जहां पे ये पिछली बार कॉन्ट्रैक्शन की बात करें तो 24.4% तक की कॉन्ट्रैक्शन देखी गई थी लास्ट ईयर में. एंड दिस इज नॉट ओनली सिग्नल अ स्ट्रॉन्ग रिवाइवल बट ऑल्सो अ पोटेंशियल इकोनॉमिक रिबाउंड इन अ बिगर वे. नाउ विद कंट्रीज न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी, एजुकेशन इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट्स अ लॉन्ग टर्म मेजर बट इट डिसाइड्स हाउ द इकोनॉमी would evolve and economy would grow because employment and entrepreneurship would be generated with a new education policy, right? The focus ki gayi hai India ko skill karne ki aur jo objective hai is to have a substantial rise, right? And the government is celebrating Azadi ka Amrit Mahotsav. This is the 75 year of independence where government encapsulate the vision of redefining India in the next 25 year. So aane wale 25 saal mein India ki kya road map honi chahiye uske liye bhi government kaam kar rahi hai. And we as an individual would also need to contribute in the government efforts. Right, coinciding with the important periods, the India ki jo growth trajectory hai, that is moving with a great pace. World economic khas karke baat kare, World Expo 2020, to Dubai mein jo abhi ho rahi hai, usme as a global community, as a participant, India is also having a pavilion. And the expo has begun from 1st of October and it will last till March 31st. Now, Indian Pavilion at Expo ki baat kare, which is being held in Dubai. So this venue is also important for you. So it will showcase country's rich cultural heritage, jahan pe India ki kya vibrancy hai, kya diversity hai, cultural diversities, kya kya opportunities wo offer karti hai dusre countries ko, wo sari cheeze portray ki jayegi and a new India to the world would be forecasted. And the country's sustained objective of opportunity would the full display, जहाँ पे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने अलग अलग मिनिस्ट्रीज और स्टेट के साथ कोऑर्डिनेट किए हैं. एंड इंडिया पार्टिसिपेट इन एक्सपो 2020 इज डिपेंडेंट अपॉन रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द इंडिया एंड यूएई. कुछ रिफॉर्म इनिशिएटिव्स की बात करें जो कि काफ़ी इंपॉर्टेंट रही हैं. सो इंडिया इज अ फास्ट इमर्जिंग एंड अ ग्लोबल इकोनॉमिक हब राइडिंग हाई ऑन रिफॉर्म एंड वराइटी ऑफ रिलेम्स. तो कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट इनिशिएटिव्स की अगर बात करें, सो गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज टैक्स, रियल स्टेट रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी ऑल्सो नोन एज रेरा, जहाँ पे बहुत सारे ऐसे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं जो इंस्टॉल प्रोजेक्ट्स होते हैं, उसमें बहुत हद तक कमी आई है बिकॉज दे आर द नोडल बॉडी वुड बी लुकिंग इन टू द कम्पलीशन ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स, बेसिकली द रेजिडेंशियल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. लेबर लॉज गवर्नमेंट लेकर के आई, जहाँ पे 3 लेबर लॉज लेकर के गवर्नमेंट आई थी, विच इज़ अगेन हेल्पिंग द लेबरर्स. इंडस्ट्री फ्रीज एफ डी आई पॉलिसीज वेयर लिबरलाइजेशन हैज़ बिन गिवन, बहुत जगह में जो परसेंटेज ऑफ एफ डी आई की लिबरलाइजेशन है वो बढ़ी है. एंड प्रोडक्शन लिंक इन्वेस्टिंग स्कीम जिसको PLI स्कीम्स भी कहते हैं, कम से कम गवर्नमेंट ने 10 सेक्टर ऐसे आइडेंटिफाई किए हैं जिसमें PLI स्कीम को लिंक की गई है. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रिसेंट इनिशिएटिव बाय द गवर्नमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ रिवाइवल ऑफ द इकॉनमी. Now, benefits of the government scheme, जो आम इंसान है, जो different, खास करके जो common citizen है, how they are getting benefited. So, the government try and aims to, you know, standardize the living of standard for the poor, needy and marginalized section of the society. And this scheme are not only empowering people, but also helping the government to include every nook and corner of the country with the growth journey. और ये जो स्कीम है सच एज उज्ज्वला योजना एंड प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण योजना अन्य योजना टारगेटेड टू बेनिफिट द पुअर एंड मार्जिनलाइज सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी. नाउ व्हाट वुड बी द कंक्लूजन ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव. सपोज इफ यू राइटिंग दिस इन मेंस पेपर, सो यू कैन कंक्लूड दैट इंडिया इज ऑन अ पाथ ऑफ सस्टेन जीडीपी ग्रोथ एंड विल टेक अ कंट्री टूवर्ड्स 5 trillion इकोनॉमी एंड बियॉन्ड. और जो नेक्स्ट 25 ईयर है विल शो इंडियाज गोल्डन ग्रोथ फेज एंड इंडिया वुड इन्वाइट द ग्लोबल कम्युनिटी टू पार्टिसिपेट्स इन द जर्नी ऑफ रिसर्जेंट न्यू इंडिया. सो अ न्यू इंडिया इज ओनली पॉसिबल वन विद collaborated efforts by the government ministries. Also at the same time we need to ensure that we are having an equal participants from other countries as well. The investment in India is essentially required to India provide new global hub to India in terms of manufacturing, space, IT and many other sectors, right? So this is how you can conclude your answers. Now moving to the MCQ questions of the day, before I proceed just to tell you the answers of yesterday questions. For the first question, the correct option is B. For the second question, the correct option is D. Now, Global Education Monitoring Report is released by United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, United Nations Child Emergency Fund, United Nations Public Administration Program and World Bank. So what you have to do, if you know the correct answer, do write that answer in the comment section. If you don't know, do have an intelligence guessing so that you can check out how does your intelligence guess work. Second, regarding the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center, it is under the control of Prime Minister's Office. The scheme of 14C was appointed in October, approved in 2018 to deal with the types of cyber crime comprehensive and coordinated manner. Right. So this is the questions from current affairs, possibly can be asked in the main in the prelims also. So do check it out. Write your answer in the comment section. Participates in the question answer quizzes. Right. So this is all about the daily news and editorial analysis, followed by the MCQs. If you have any other concern, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Thank you so much for watching.